Hello and welcome guys, and welcome to this short vlog. And yes, barely 3 months to go for your examination. And within these 3 months, if we engage ourselves in some specific strategic goal-oriented strategy to complete our syllabus, we are going to achieve success in our forthcoming examination. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about the 100 marks paper which you have in your group 4 in CMA final, which is cost and management audit. How to attain good marks in that subject, how to do some smart study, how to do some intelligent work in preparing your course material, and how to employ the next 3 months absolutely perfectly so that we can attain good marks in cost and management audit. Rider number one. Guys, cost and management audit is one of the most scoring subjects which you have in your group 4. It will benefit you by giving you extra marks, which can actually be used for setting off the shortfall in the other subjects. And yes, it has ever been proved in history that this subject is best for getting the set off benefit. Yes, it is very, very scoring. Course content is limited. And yes, you have to just study the study matter of the institute to cover the entire syllabus, and you are done. You are done. So in this particular video, I'm going to detail out the course plan which I have for the next 3 months and how to give your best shot in the next 3 months. Yes, I'll be discussing syllabus 2016 as well as syllabus 2022 for the time being, because still it has got one attempt to go. So yes guys, this is your syllabus for cost and management audit. So this is the course content of cost and management audit for both syllabus 2016 and 2022. I'll be pinpointing on the differences between the two syllabus while I'm doing discussion on this. Okay, now guys, this actually is content from my book. If you're using my course, my book, then it is divided into two parts, volume 1 and volume 2. If you're using institute study mat, then this distinction is not there, so it doesn't matter. You just focus on the chapters. Okay, now first and foremost important chapter which is there in your syllabus is cost, Companies Cost Records and Audit Rule 2014. Both practical and theoretical portion are important from this particular chapter. And especially for 2022 syllabus students, value addition, practical question of value addition is very, very important from this particular chapter. So I've given it in this particular chapter in my book. If you are referring to CMA study mat, then it will be given in some other chapter. That's perfectly all right. I'm just pinpointing the topic. Value addition is very, very important. And for syllabus 2016 and 2022, both syllabus, reconciliation of profit is very, very important. These are two practical questions which are obvious for coming in the examination, in the forthcoming examination, because they've been getting repeated in past. Okay, so these are two practical questions which are very, very important. You must do them. And for theory, all the rules which are there, the determination of audit rules, the how to what is the monetary threshold of determining the rules, everything is very, very important from this particular chapter. So very, very important chapter. Mark it as important. Next important chapter is professional ethics. Yes, some students feel that professional ethics is not an important chapter. Guys, absolutely wrong. Professional ethics is a very, very important chapter. Yes, do not you don't need to mug up all the schedules and all the contents which are there. Okay, don't need to mug them up. Just read them so that you're able to understand what is the difference between them, and that's okay. Okay, don't mug them up. But a very, very important chapter from exam perspective. In syllabus 2022 as well, in the last examination, a question from this particular chapter came. It's obvious that this chapter will come in both the its importance is there in both 16 and 22 syllabus. And now comes the most important chapter, cost accounting standards. Guys, cost accounting standard 1 to 10 are the most important cost accounting standard from a practical and theory standpoint. And cost accounting standards from 11 to 12, 24, they are relatively less important. So what you need to do is you need to just study the uncommon points. The uncommon points in CAS 11 to 24. What do you mean by uncommon points? So there's mostly in all the CAS, there are certain common points. Like finance cost is excluded while computing the cost. This is a common point in all the cost accounting standards. 11 to 24, do not read the uncommon points. Just cut them out. Just read the uncommon points. That's it. And you'll be able to solve any answer, any question in the examination. Okay. Practical and theory, both are important from cost accounting standard, because in the examination both of them have been coming. Okay, specifically CAS 2 capacity determination. Okay, specifically this particular chapter, cost accounting standard, is very, very important from a practical standpoint specifically. And I'm not undermining the practical which comes in other chapters as well, like direct expenses or employee cost. They are also important, but most important is this capacity term, CAS 2. Now coming on to volume 2, in the new syllabus this entire portion is for 50 marks direct pure theory. Okay, in the new syllabus, I'm talking about the new syllabus. In the old syllabus, I'll change the color of my pen so that you're not confused. In old syllabus, these three chapters from a theory standpoint are very, very important. In old syllabus 2016, so 2022 syllabus, entire these chapters contain 50 marks. Syllabus 2016, these three chapters will come for about 20 marks. So yes, guys, theoretical portion is very, very important from an exam standpoint. This is all about theory. Okay, this cost auditing standards not that important. Just remember the names and numbers of these cost auditing standard and a few principles. Okay, that will suffice. Filing of cost audit report in XBRL format, not important, not much important. Okay, just read it once. Management reporting issue under cost audit. Do the practical questions which are there in this particular topic. That's it. But these are specifically the most important chapters. So the last three chapters are not there in old syllabus. So in the old syllabus, first three chapters having weightage of 20 to 25 marks. In new syllabus, these chapters from 8th to 15th having a weightage of 50 marks. So now you obviously understand what is the importance of this particular scheme of chapters. You understand it yourself. Okay, what I've done in my book, if you are referring to my book, I've summarized all these chapters, make them so crisp, so easy to remember and understand that you won't be able to you won't be facing any problem in revising them or learning them. Okay, because at the end of the day, guys, theory is all about learning. So learn it practically and theoretically and understand it and just remember the important points of it. So I've done all this in my book, so you won't face any problem with that respect. Okay, so yes, this was the volume 2. I specifically emphasize a lot because it is relatively theoretical, so you will find it a little monotonous to do. But if you do it, now sure shot marks are there in the examination. Sure shot marks are there. When I'm getting sure shot marks, I would not leave any stone unturned to cover my volume number 2, which is the theoretical portion, specifically in syllabus 22, where this particular part is coming for 50 marks, direct 50 marks, guys. Undoubtedly, there's no option. I mean, there's no chance that it will come less than 50 marks. Section B is dedicated to these theoretical portions. That is the benefit of this particular portion. Okay, so yes, that's all for this analysis of mine, guys. I'll be coming up with analysis of BVM SPM as well. I'll be discussing the other subjects as well with you so that you achieve good marks in your examination. And yes, all the very best for examination, guys. Please do well. Very less time left, but it's very, very critical that you use this time efficiently to make it your best time and to reap the best benefit for your examination. All the very best and happy studying.